studies. I remember a video I saw of you at Rackspace, and then I think there was one of Schwab, and then what was the other one that you shared? So really helpful stories of how impactful this whole idea of Net Promoter and not the score, but Net Promoter System. Do you want to say more about that?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And the overarching message of winning on purpose is that it's not just NPS and marketing success is one of 10 things you have to get right. It's the foremost thing. It's the center of the universe. And the world doesn't see it that way yet. Most companies think, yeah, I've got a lot of stakeholders. Customers are important, but so are shareholders and employees and the environment and social governance issues. And they're all, and of course they are. And yet if you don't pick one as the center of your purpose, your existence, you just start kidding yourself and you'll give mediocre results to all of those stakeholders.
Yeah. So you did a good job of explaining why it's important to come back to that now and what the white space was for the book. What do you think are the most common misperceptions that people and companies have about Net Promoter Score?
Oh, I think they believe that you can make it a KPI or a bonus target. Mm-hmm. And that's how you can get people to take it seriously. In fact, it destroys its credibility and makes it a joke, because surveys are so easy to manipulate and so few people understand the subtleties behind sample bias and response bias and, you know, stuff that scientists and medical researchers understand, but they go to grad school for a couple of years to finally understand it. And a lot of people just don't understand the subtlety and the soft nature of surveys, nor do they think carefully how hard it is for people to speak the truth and giving feedback when they know that it might hurt that person, you know, whether it's an Uber driver or a customer service rep at American Express. You know, but if you link it to their bonus, then the customer is not going to give negative feedback. They're just going to give courtesy 10s or courtesy 5 stars. Because, you know, frankly, what they're frustrated about is something other than that person that they're dealing with. It's something in the system or a process flaw. And so you basically shut down the ability to gather honest, constructive feedback.
Yeah.